Students, today we will discuss about development. It is the first content of CC1 paper of DLED part 1. We will discuss about development and its principles. So first of all, you have to know that education aims at the all-round development of an individual, or you can say education aims at the all-round harmonious, that means balanced development of an individual. And the development of a nation depends upon the development of children, which helps the nation for its progress. So the development of proper attitude, habits, patterns of behavior formed during its early years, means the early years of the child, determines to a great extent how successfully an individual will adjust if he grows older. Means the all attitudes, habits, practices, patterns of behavior which he develops helps the child in order to be a successful civilized citizen of the society. That is compulsory. A child has to develop all these attributes in order to cope up with the situation, that is the present needs and its demands. So it is imperative, means it is vital, crucial, you can say crucial, essential, that the teachers who are charged with the responsibility of the development of the child should be familiar with the importance of development. Means the teacher in the primary, upper primary, means the up to 8th, that is elementary level, the teachers who are engaged in teaching profession should know about the development of the child, means the need of the development of the child, and they should be responsible, they should be active, they should help the child to be familiar, or you can say the teacher should assist the child in order to be a good human being through the development that has occurred in the course of time. So it is imperative, vital or crucial for the teachers who are engaged with the responsibility of the development of the child should be familiar with the need, with importance of the development, which is part and parcel of a human life. Right. In the words of E.B. Hellrock, the term development means progress, series of changes that occur in a orderly, predictable pattern as a result of maturation and experience. Means in the words of E.B. Hellrock, the term development means a progress, a series of changes that occur in a orderly expected pattern as a result of maturation and experiences. So there are various areas that are related with the development of a child. So what are the various areas that are related to the development of the child. The various areas are physical development, social development, language development, emotional development, creative development, intellectual development, aesthetic appreciation development. These are the areas which are interrelated, or which are the areas that are related with the development of the child. So if you think about physical and motor development, it means physical growth, strengthening of bones, muscles. If you go for physical development, you will find the child learns to interact with the other members of society, means the people, the society, the friends, the peer groups of the society. Language development means they will able to speak, they are able to listen to the various sounds, they can speak, right? And ultimately, after they have attained some maturity, they will be able to read and write. Next is emotional development, means recognize and manage feelings, expressions. Creative development means imagination, thinking. They can suppose they are participating in drama, they are participating in dance competition, art competition, right? Cognitive development means intellectual development, means they will be able to remember, right? Cognitive and intellectual development, remember, they will be able to recognize, they will be able to be, they will be intelligent, they will gradually they will be able to develop their reasoning abilities, right? Aesthetic appreciation means to appreciate beauty and art, means they will love art, they will appreciate it, they will share their views after they have gone through the art, you know, they will appreciate, they will praise the various forms of art. So social, the various areas of the development of the child are the social development, means a child learns to interact with other members of society. Physical development means coordination of hands and the brain, physical development, motor development, they will be able to develop their muscles, their bones, physical growth and structure. Language development means first they will listen, they will speak, then after attaining a basic maturity, they will be able to read and write. Emotional development, they will share their emotions, joys. Creative expression, they will be able to take part in various activities which will help to develop their creativity. They will take participation in art, music, dance, drama, cognitive intellectual development, reasoning abilities, thinking abilities. They will be able to predict. They will be able to remember. Next is to appreciate beauty and art, that is aesthetic appreciation development. So these are the various areas that are related to the development of the child, and all this development helps the child to be a successful, to be a civilized citizen of the society, right? So education means an harmonious all-round development which helps the child to satisfy he needs, his desires, and moreover, he develops his personality in order to be a good human being. Right? He develops his morals, he develops his ideas, habits, practices. He gets involved in various good aspects, I mean good attributes he get acquainted to. So the various areas that are related to the development of a child. So you have first learned what is development and what are the areas related to the development of the child. So now you will I will discuss about. So development is a series. So the development is a series of orderly progression of change towards maturity. Means when the child gets matured, the development occurs. Means it continues. It's a series of events. It's a series of events which helps the child to get maturity, to attain maturity. And moreover, you should also note that in this procedure, in this entire procedure, health and hygiene, basic needs of children, food, water, balanced diet, helps the child in attaining the goals related to the various aspects of development. Right? So the development is a series of events which helps the child to attain the maturity. And moreover, in this entire process, there are various factors which helps the child to develop, which helps the child to develop through this entire process. Basic amenities, health, hygiene, food, medicines, and moreover, the entire procedure. This entire procedure is carried out through a sequence of events. Right? So, from the various scientific knowledge gathered through observation, some principles have emerged. These principles enable the parents and the teachers to understand how children develop, how to guide them and provide favorable environment for their optimum development, means ideal development, perfect development, excellent development, means from the scientific knowledge gained, means from previous research, various researches through observation, it has been observed that some principles are there which are deeply related with the development of the child. So what are the principles? So please note the principles. Principles of continuous development means the development is a continuous process. It takes place according to the age. Suppose 0 to 2 years, 2 to 6 years, right? After 7 to 12 years, 12 to 14 years. It is a change that is takes place in a continuous process. Next is principle of sequential development. What does it mean, principle of sequential development? It means, first of all, the development of the organ takes place, and after the development of the organ, the physical structure takes place. Means sequential. This is not haphazard. It is arranged in a proper sequence. Sequential. It is unique development. Means principle of unique development. Unique means it differs from child to child. Means each and every child does not develop in the same way. Suppose a child first starts to sit, then the child starts to crawl, then the child starts to walk. So this is the procedure. So it differs among the child. Means all the child does not develop in the same way. I mean, they develop in the same way, but their variation is different. Some develop in a very short period of time. Some of the child takes a longer period of time to develop. Means develop take place, but it differs from individual to individual. Principle of interaction of heredity and environment. Means interaction means exchange. Interaction means link, association. So heredity means the genes which you have got from your parents. And environment means the society. So development takes place with the exchange, with the reaction of our genes which we have got from our parents with the environment, with the, suppose with the people of the community, with the habits and practice of the community, with the, by suppose the child mix with the other child of the society. So he is interacting, he is exchanging his views, his opinion with the other people of society. So interaction, development is the interaction of heredity and environment. Principle of difference of development means suppose the female grow faster in compared to males. It has been proved by various experiments. There are many theories which have proved that the females grow faster than the males. In principle of development. Principle of cumulative development. Cumulative means changes. The development does not come all of a sudden. Means changes do not come all of a sudden. Each change is the culmination of his previous growth and experience. Means the child grows, the child gets mature, and slowly they try to develop. Means the development is related to the previous one. Means it is every stages of development is related with the previous one. Means it is a modification of the previous development. Principle of interaction between maturity and learning. Maturity means development of thinking abilities. Learning means through experiences. Means the child develops his thinking abilities. The child gains experience through various activities which helps the child to develop in the future. Means principle of interaction between maturity and learning. So first of all, you have to know principle of continuous development, principle of sequential development, it is development of the organ, then the physical structure of the body. Principle of unique development means variation among the child. Some go in a very short duration, some child needs a longer period of time to develop. Principle of interaction between heredity and environment. Principle of difference of development of females and males. Principle of interaction between maturity and learning. So these are the various developments, principles of development which we have learned today. So if we recapitulate what we have learned, so you have to know that education brings an all-round harmonious development of the child, right, and which helps the child to be a good citizen, which helps the child to be a good human being, first of all. But what are the areas? The areas of development are physical development, emotional development, social development, cognitive intellectual development, language development. These are various areas that are related to the development of the child. And moreover, we have also learned that the basic needs of the child, the food, the medicine, health and hygiene, water, are the ingredients which help the child to develop. And moreover, there are various principles, continuous development, principle of sequential development, principle of cumulative development, principle of difference between male and female, principle of interaction between maturity and learning, principle of the interaction or exchange, you can say, of heredity and environment, right? These are the various development principles that we have learned today, right? So in the next class, we will discuss about what are the objectives of development. Thank you.